The purpose of any sports Hall of Fame is to separate an elite few from a cast of thousands. These are the ones we choose to remember. It's every sport's ultimate honor. So then what do we say about those who exceed the ultimate? Win 30 races, and you'll probably make the Hall. Jeff Gordon won 93.
This is the greatest day of my life.
Win a championship, automatic consideration. Jeff Gordon won 4. Emerge at a young age.
And there's Jeff Gordon, victorious.
Reach stardom almost overnight.
Jeff Gordon wins the inaugural Brickyard 400.
Superstardom shortly after.
Wonderful is here.
Become the face of the sport. Take it to unprecedented heights. If you do any single one of those things, you're a Hall of Famer. But Jeff Gordon, he did all of those things.
Jeff Gordon's going to win his third Daytona 500.
It is Jeff Gordon's 7th Darlington victory.
There's a certain charisma required for that, isn't there? Richard Petty had it. So did Earnhardt.
Tonight, Gordon ties Earnhardt for career wins.
Jeff Gordon was the guy who made those who never noticed take notice. That's what people mean when they use the word transcendent. Jeff Gordon made our sport matter to a larger world. And for that, the term Hall of Famer just isn't big enough.
It's so incredible to sit here with you and watch those highlights, because I know you had mentioned that that's what gets you the most is watching some of the old highlights. What do you think when you see that? And you hear Jimmy's words.
Oh, yeah. And I mean, I have my mom and dad here that got me into racing. And, you know, to me, I look back at my career, and if I had to pinpoint one thing, it was timing. For me, you know, when I got into quarter midget racing, when I maybe raced on ESPN Thursday Night Thunder, that sort of elevated up my name into the racing world. When I first came to North Carolina and met Hugh Connerty or Ray Evernham or, you know, Bill Davis, and then, of course, Rick Hendrick. I mean, the timing of all those things and how they happened and what that did to get myself in the position to win so many races. And that, really, I excelled at the highest level. I won races prior to getting into NASCAR, but I won the most and the most consistent, and I had the best team of people around me at the highest level. And that you got to, it's a lot more than just talent. That's got to be, you know, a lot of luck and a lot of great timing.
How has your NASCAR career and all the success that you had over the years shaped who you are as a person today?
Oh, yeah. Everything I know in my whole life is I've learned through racing, whether it be business, whether it be how to be, a better friend, a husband, a father, you know, racing, the discipline that it takes to be good at racing, and how you have to work with one another, the adversity you have to overcome, the obstacles, the good days, the bad days, all those things, they all relate to life in general. And I'm the person that I am today because racing really either taught me something that led me to take that experience off track, or it somehow kind of molded me into the person that I am.
When you're on the track every single week racing with the competitors, you know, we're always just looking ahead to the next race. Now that you've been out of that car and you've been able to kind of look down on it, do you recognize the impact that you've had on this sport? Do you see it through the eyes of the other competitors?
I mean, I lived through it, so I know that the time that I came into the sport was thriving, and all of a sudden, a new, young, different face came along from California via Indiana and open wheel racing. Like I said, the time was right. It, because maybe I wasn't fully accepted when I came in, but it didn't take long for fans and competitors to start embracing that and be open to it. Of course, we started going to Indianapolis and Texas and Southern California and, you know, the Northeast, Midwest. And so I feel like a lot of amazing things lined up at the right time. And because of that, I was one of many at that time that I feel like contributed to the growth of NASCAR.
What's your greatest memory in a race car, Jeff?
My standard answer, because I get asked this, is always the inaugural Brickyard 400. But I got to say, that final race at Martinsville, to win that race, what that meant to go to Homestead and battle for a championship in my final race, And of course, Inger and the kids were there. That was nothing can top that.